Hi guys! So guess what?
Pretty sure you guys already know about this because I've talked about it on Snapchat or at least on Twitter. I got a new iPhone, finally! I have the iPhone, was it 5? Forever. And mine, I don't know, maybe some of y'all's iPhone 5s are still doing really great. Mine was slowly, actually pretty fast, dying, and it wouldn't hold a charge. It was just terrible. I couldn't do anything on it, so I always used Bruce's phone. And yeah, I needed my own phone. So my mom got me the iPhone 8. Oh my gosh, it was this or the 8 Plus, but the 8 Plus was way too big, so I chose the regular 8. I know the other one's a little bit better, but I can't hold them when they're so big. So I got this one, and I'm so excited. And thank you guys so much for recommending the case. I really like it. It's the OtterBox. So far, so good. I want to do a video on what is on my phone, my top favorite apps. I'm not going to go through every single one of them, but I am going to say a few of my favorites and look through them together with you guys. I still have the generic a screensaver on here of the wallpaper. I just have not changed it yet, so yeah. It looks like that. Quick, before I get on with the rest of the video, and I know it got dark, don't worry. It'll go back to daytime in the rest of the video. But I have a giveaway for you guys from Yode Watches. If you haven't heard of them, you should, because they're amazing. I know a ton of influencers that have watches by them, and they are absolutely amazing. I'll show you this one on, and look at the box it comes in. It has a magnetic top to it. And even a magnetic drawer that comes out in the front. And the winner of the giveaway will win a $180 gift card to this website so you can pick out a watch that you want. So I chose this pink one. It is so pretty on. I love the wood band. So, funny story about these watches. When the brand contacted me, I had asked one for Bruce because Bruce and I weren't gonna do Christmas presents this year. But I was like, oh my god, he loves watches. And so they were nice enough to send me one for him as well. He will be here in a little bit to show you guys the watch he picked out. But it was so exciting. I wrapped up the present and put it among our fake presents. We wrap fake presents. And then I pulled it out on Christmas morning and gave it to him, and he loved it. He was so excited. So, oh, it was amazing. If you want to enter the giveaway, all you have to do is click on the link below and it'll give you instructions on what you need to do. They're going to pick the winner and you will win a $180 gift card. And I also down below have a coupon code for $25 off if you're interested in buying anything from their site, and you do get free sizing with it so you can make sure that it fits good. Versus watch. Look at that. All right, let's show it to them on. It looks so good on you. I love it. Now daytime, back to the apps. I'm gonna pick out my top favorite apps. So I'm gonna start off with one I just gotten for the new year, and you guys are gonna love this, and we can actually be friends on it, so it'll be kind of fun. I'm on, well, I'm supposed to be on a ketogenic diet. I've been taking a little bit of a break because of the holidays, but really good diet for me. I really love it. I feel great on it, but it is very hard to stay on just because it's a very low carb, and our world just revolves around carbs. Like, everything quick is a carb. So it's very hard to kind of stay on track while you have all this other stuff going on. But anyway, I downloaded this one app. It's called Good or Bad, and it is an app that helps you stay on track food-wise, and it's not a lot of work, which is great because I have so much that I'm doing right now with moving that I just want something simple that can help me stay on my diet. So on the app, for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, you would go on and you rate. I'm gonna rate breakfast.
It's a super simple meal logging app.
And it says, how was your breakfast? Good, okay, or bad. So it's really simple. You could just choose which one it was. This morning, I'm not gonna lie guys, I had leftover P.F. Chang's egg rolls, so bad. It was not good for me. I can write a little note in here. P.F. Chang's. I didn't take a picture of it. You can take pictures, which I am gonna start doing to hold myself even more accountable.
Can you believe I had that for breakfast? What is wrong with me? And I'm gonna hit okay.
Then you would go through and you can add snacks and all that stuff. And so this is my past day. You can see how my day went. It went not so great. I had a good breakfast, an okay lunch, not so great dinner, definitely not good on snacks and alcohol. We went out. And you can kind of see your day here. So the reason I really like it is because it does hold me accountable, especially if I have friends added on here, which you guys can add me if you download the app. My username is just Teresa Hurado. They have some stats and you can just see how you've been doing. You really think before you eat something, you're like, which face is this gonna be? Is this gonna be the happy face or is this gonna be the bad face? And it tailors to every diet because you yourself are the one who decides if it's good or bad. A plate full of rice and vegetables might be good for someone, But it's not good for me because of ketogenic, you're not supposed to have that many carbs. So it's nice that this, you can be on any diet you want and use it to help you. I've been loving that. It's called Good or Bad. It's a free app. You don't have to pay for it or anything. You can go check that out. The links to everything down below. And don't forget to add me if you go on it. My next favorite app is probably absolute favorite, which you guys know. I mean, everyone uses it. It's Facetune. Some people will go overboard, push themselves in and all this stuff. What I like it for is lightening backgrounds. It can lighten the background, and if you're wearing makeup or something colorful, it really makes that pop because the background's pretty white. And also just adding a little bit extra to your makeup picture, you use the details button. Let's open a photo. This is just something I had on Snapchat. If you use the details button right here, then you can like make something pop. Like, I don't know why I'd want my eye to pop, but if I did, boom, you can see it's the focus of the picture now. It's like my number one photo app of all time. I haven't tried Facetune 2, I know there's a second one, but that one you have to pay like a monthly subscription for, and I'm sorry, that is not in the budget right now, so I stick to this one. I've watched a lot of videos on how to edit your pictures, and James Charles has the best one that I've seen so far with how he edits his makeup pictures, so I learned a lot of tips from that. So if you guys are interested in how to make your pictures look like, you know, the top beauty gurus and all that stuff, definitely watch his video. It's so informative, and he shows you how to use like Facetune and all that stuff to do it. I'm not gonna name the givens, which are like Snapchat, Instagram. Those are obviously like everyone's kind of favorite apps. I'm gonna cheat a little bit, and I hope it's okay with you guys, but there's a couple apps that I have not gotten a chance to put on my new phone just yet. They are on Bruce's phone because, like I said, I used his phone all the time before. So I'm gonna show you a couple of them that I have on his phone that I'm absolutely obsessed with. The first one is a game, and I forget how much it is, if it's like $2 or $3, and I showed this to you in a vlog before. I had never heard of it, but it was trending one day, and I decided to download it, and it was so much fun. It's called Hidden Folk. Hidden Folks, I think. You like find stuff. These are all the list of things you have to find. And stuff here moves, and you can like look for stuff. And all the sound effects are like people's voices. Some people hate it. I love it. I think it's so cute. And you just like click around, you try and find stuff. There's little hints that they give you where you can actually like use your brain and smarts to try and find it. So I think that's so much fun. And just being able to like move stuff in their world, just so cool. So I love that game. Definitely something I do at night, it relaxes me. The next one is 1Q. It's a free app that I downloaded one day. So basically what it is, like a survey app, they send you one question at a time. And they send you the questions, I don't know, once every couple months. Like, it is not that often. But for every question that you get sent, you get 25 cents, they immediately deposit it into your PayPal account. So that's freaking amazing. And I know it's just like 25 cents, but still, it's why not, you know? So far I've only made 50 cents, but I still like it because, you know, you put a push notification on, it says, oh, you have a question, you answer it, it's literally one question, and you get paid immediately. Like, it shows up in your PayPal account within minutes. So I'll have links down below. I think there's like a referral program. So if you click on my link, I make some money, and then you can send it to your friends, and then you can make some money if they sign up. So definitely cool. And this last one is a food one because you know how obsessed I am with food. I love food. I love ordering food. For some reason, I don't like home cooked meals. I never have. I don't know why. And it can be from anyone. I've tried some really good home cooked food, but I like it at a restaurant. I'm weird like that. And we recently found this one because our favorite Chinese restaurant stopped delivering with Grubhub and Eat24 and Yelp and all like the main ones. And then I found Beyond Menu, which may be a main one now. I don't know, I've never heard of it. And it is amazing. They have a pretty good amount of restaurants, but basically I just like it because they have my favorite one and they're easy to use. I've never had a problem with delivery, so I'm in love with that. Those are my top apps so far, 2018. I definitely want to go through and do a what's on my iPhone video, but I just thought I would do the top ones right now, what I've been loving so far this year. So, and it's only been a few weeks now, so. But thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know down below any apps you think I should check out. I love nice, peaceful game apps. I hate games like Flappy Bird, stuff that makes my heart race and I get really like antsy and stuff. Kind of games that when you're a kid, it would make you want to throw your Game Boy on, like, across the room. Nothing like that. I don't like those. Anything nice and relaxing, social apps, food apps, anything like that. Leave that down below so I can check them out. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!